Renewable energy is energy that is collected from a natural source and can be replenished on a human timescale, and these include solar, wind, and even tidal energy. What is crucial in a society is that there is a stable and abundant supply of energy. Conventionally, we have heavily relied on oil and coal to do so, but because these are finite resources, they'll one day run out. Not to mention, they also produce a lot of greenhouse gases such as carbon dioxide and methane, which ultimately contribute to the enhanced greenhouse effect. Currently in Hong Kong, more than 50% of the fuel mix consists of coal, and only 2% consists of renewable energy. As a result of using copious amounts of fossil fuels, two-thirds of our CO2 emissions in Hong Kong originates from the local power plants. In terms of economic impact, integrating more green energy sources into our society creates more jobs in the energy sector, which in turn stimulates domestic economic growth. However, the downside is that this isn't a cost-effective solution in comparison to coal power plants, and this will be discussed later on in the video. Positive environmental impacts include reduced carbon emissions and emission of pollutants in general. The downside includes destroying the natural habitat of animals in order to allocate space to build the infrastructures, for example, the Aral Sea and its irrigation canals. There are four major issues with using renewable energy, also known as the four imperatives, and this include power density, energy density, cost, and scale. Take, for example, CLP's offshore wind farm in the southeastern waters of Hong Kong. It's a $7 billion project consisting of 67 wind turbines, yet it can only generate around 1% of the energy demand in Hong Kong, whilst also increasing consumer tariffs by 2%. This is known as lower energy density. And although Hong Kong households are willing to spend more money to go green, the cost of wind power is around 200% the price of coal combustion, which means that if the city went all wind, consumers' electricity bills will substantially increase. The intermittent nature of solar and wind power sources, for example, are also unable to provide a reliable supply. The issue of low energy density is significant because it means that even if the technology is there, lots of land is still needed to generate sufficient energy. And given the astronomically high cost and scarcity of available land, as well as the increasing support for using green space for housing, the feasibility of actually allocating land for onshore green energy infrastructures is low. In addition, Hong Kong residents do not have the right to modify their apartment with distributed energy resources, and this means that they can't benefit from renewable energy and contribute to a greener society. Instead, this is determined by building developers and parent corporate groups who often have a conservative and business-driven motive. In an interview with Professor Leung from the Department of Mechanical Engineering in Hong Kong U, he noted that there is a lack of renewable energy policies currently in place. He urged that if the government had the determination to enact these policies, as well as investing in resources with great potential such as biofuel, Hong Kong is actually in a position to achieve certain energy goals. Current solutions to the said issues include establishing a scheme of control agreement between the government and CLP for continual technological development. There is also the implementation of a feed-in tariff system alongside the promotion of distributed generation of energy. In conclusion, renewable energy definitely has its potential as a major source of energy, but until the social, economic, and technological issues are resolved, we believe that there is still a long way to go until our society can truly be powered in a sustainable manner.